Anne Cairns is one of New Zealand's veteran paddlers. She's raced for New Zealand in canoe, slalom, outrigger canoeing, and is a three-time whitewater rafting world champion. How about that?
And she's about to switch codes again to flatwater kayaking when she heads to the Rio Olympics, and this time for Samoa. Anaole Karima Fai'ai has this story.
Danny Burke, best known for its Scandinavian influence, is also home to one of New Zealand's top paddlers.
Being based in Danny Burke, I don't have access to water close by, so it just means I have to be, a little bit more organised.
Anne Cairns spends much of her day travelling, her training spots located half an hour from home and another hour from work. But when you're an Olympic kayaker for Samoa, it's all worth the effort.
It's just a great opportunity that you wouldn't turn down. And my Samoan side is as important as my Kiwi side, so I'm proud to represent Samoa this time around.
It comes as a dream come true for the 35-year-old who missed out on Olympic qualification in 2008 with the New Zealand K4 crew when a Hungarian teammate had her residency declined.
I think Kayaking New Zealand learned a lot from that experience. It was hugely disappointing, but you learn from experiences like that, and I think it makes you stronger.
She then faded from the sport, but thanks to Lisa Carrington's gold medal win in 2012, Anne decided to give her Olympic dream another crack, this time for Samoa.
I knew that there was potentially going to be a continental spot come available based on, what she might be able to achieve in the 2015 qualifiers, that she might get a direct ticket through to the Olympics, and if that happened, then there could be a place for another Oceania spot to come available. Back then, that's what triggered me to get back in a K1 and start training.
Anne secured the spot after strong finishes at the Oceania Champs earlier this year, and her mum couldn't be prouder.
I never think about feel like anything's like this in my life when Anne's going to the Olympics. It's wonderful. I feel like crying. I'm the luckiest mum in the world. I'm so proud of my daughter.
It's been Annie's dream for a while now. So definitely. She asked me 4 years ago if she could, give it her best shot for it, and who am I to say no? So, I'm very proud. Her goals are going to come soon.
Samoa isn't able to contribute much financially to Anne's campaign, so she's had to work full-time as a firefighter to help fund her overseas trips. Fortunately, though, it's provided more than just financial support.
Just using some of the gear is, physical enough, but there's training rostered into our day, and there's always times, on the weekends and things to jump in and maybe do a little bit extra. So, it works, works hand in hand.
The community have also jumped on board to help her out, including free access to this man-made lake in Tagata.
It's only sort of 750 metres long, and sometimes there are cattle and sheep grazing on the sides, which always amuses me. I have a little giggle. But for me, this is my reality of what I've got to use, and it's kind of part of my whole DIY campaign. It's not the most ideal place to train, but it's what I've got, and I'm making the most of it.
She's a three-time whitewater rafting world champion, but Anne's not expecting to repeat the same success in Rio.
I have raced against those girls this season, I've raced against them last season, and I know exactly what I'm up against.
She's glad enough to be achieving a lifelong dream and fly the Samoan flag on the world stage.
You are awesome. Another amazing person on the show this morning.
I really enjoyed this Olympic series. So many people.
Unfortunately, Marama, that's the end of our amazing program this morning. You can catch any of our stories again on TVNZ On Demand or our amazing Facebook page.
And remember, starting tomorrow is Cook Islands Language Week.
Yes,
the theme is, now I have to concentrate for this, Kia ariki au I toku tupuranga, kia ora waturai toku reo, which means to,
wow.
I know. Thank
Look
you, Johnson,
you.
For helping me there. To embrace my heritage, my language lives on.
Well, that's and we'll also have the coverage of the Cook Islands Language Week on next week's show. Have a great week, everyone. Keep warm. We'll see you next week. Ka kite.
Arira.
Well done.
Pacific people love the sauce to our new homebound. Tagata Pasifika, wanna be from town.